sitting just shy of that 300 foot mark. Looks to be sitting about 299 and change. Find out what the official number is here in a minute. Chad also came in chapter. John here, 40-55, celebrating great. He jumped out the window, sideline him for the season. Chad, since the age of the started by the metal bills. Not for Dan here, but for the top on the seat. Currently, they're going to Michigan State Arena for every business. He's looking for his program. Very ambitious young man in the seat here. Hard working, he's built his tractor basically on his own, on his dad. Looking for a good run here today. Three points for Dan Mercer. Jed sitting down there about that 275, 280 foot.
Tony Harness down inside that SFI roll cage. Has a helmet on, SFI whiplash collar underneath the helmet. Green lights and green flags. Our third smoker up here in the class.
Not the run Larry was looking for there. I don't know what quite was going on. Tractor never did build the boost, get the wheel speed up. Another tractor off the TTPA, sir. Here at Kosky, we have a roof mission and we need excessive tinkering. Ellis, 180XT. Tractor, many year veteran in the sport. Rich Rankle with the heavyweight classes. Undergoing surgery, getting the 8,000 piece of post-hoc class. This tractor is a little different than what you're going to see. This is at 300 track action. A lot of them build up 20 chargers. We'll take a little bit longer to build that boost on the line, get that turbo synced up, light off the baby turbo changes this season. It's woken this track up, getting a win earlier on. Let's see what Eric can do. Green lights, green flags for the excessive tinkering.
Boy, Eric wound up going through the one spot on the track he wanted to avoid the most, that right side at about 110 through 150. Very soft there.
Still a very nice run for excessive tinkering. He's sitting right about that 293 foot mark, roughly.
Green lights, green flags for Mike Kennedy. right out beyond that 300-foot mark. Nice run for the Bechdels, having to do a little bit of piloting on that tractor. Sitting right here about the 295-foot mark. Tow tractor, please. We need a tow tractor, please.
296 and 16 for Mike Bechdel, 296.16.
Earlier in the season, he got back together. He's made two runs in this lightweight class. Have not carried runs, to say the least.
Ordinarily, it might be a shooter. You run a 20-inch high draw bar. I think you've got it down to about 14 for this.
Yes, it's really low down there. I made a walk over there just to see how much they did drop this draw bar, trying to get this chassis to calm down.
A little bit narrower tire, as you can see on Mobile Light Limited, is 24.5 frame 2. He has to run those for super far. And there are areas in the country where that is advanced for Light Limited Super. But we have tractors here today that are up to 30.5 max. We anticipate they will become the norm here in Michigan. Ball home for a nice calm run there. He's had some bucking Bronco rides on this track pilots this bike.
Seeing for Paul, not getting that chassis to hook up the line. No, they were in their low gear, trying to slow down them tires to get them to hook. Definitely having a hard time with that chassis at that lightweight.
.267.29 for Paul, .267.29. Yeah, tracker just never got a hold of track. He never saw the governor kick in. The smoke was never as thick as it would be if he was hooked in, like you'll see him do in the Super Farm class later tonight.
Give you an idea what he's actually trying to do there. Super Farm horsepower averages between 1,300 and 1,500 horsepower. Some guys being a little bit bigger than that. You're looking to be about 1,000 to 1,100 horsepower in this light limited super stock class.
Yeah.
to get hard on that left brake, right about that 260-foot mark.
I know one thing they changed after listening to that. There's an equal length runner exhaust manifold in there now.
Yes, yes there is.
Respectable run for a tracker that's rev limited on a much smaller turbocharger as well.
Absolutely, 3,500 RPM rev limit on this on the 8,000 diesel Pro Stock class. Now, Charles, I did not get a chance to tell you, between the Smiglinski team and the Bushy team, there is a competition this year here in Armada.
302-30 for Paul Smiglinski. 302-30 puts him at second place.
This year in Armada, the Bushy and Smiglinski team are going to go heads up on who can pull the biggest wheelie the longest.
It's great house back, John Deere. Next up to try, this is another diesel Pro Stock tractor out of the TTPA. A smaller charger, red limited. Smaller tire tractor than the light limited supers.
Yes, 18.4 by 38 full cut tires go with the 8,000 diesel Pro Stock class. It's a little bit hard to get that horsepower around these tractors. See, between the 550 and 625 horsepower mark. Dennis, one of three brothers that can't be in this tractor. Brother Don and Duncan.
Light limited super stock schedule.
Getting motors to go.
Yeah, that would have been a problem. By the way, did you notice something? I was on time. I know that's my whole point. I don't know why, but...
A little bit smaller cubic inch on this one. It's only 301. The other Aldi tractors are right up to 360 max. This guy has other vision. A little bit tired. Just trying to... There's a good rest of the year here. And then redevelop the aging program this winter. Three seasons of one. That's a lot.
Let's see what I can do. Are you just on the ball?
I wasn't watching his throttle hand to see if it was him that pulled back on the reins because he thought he was headed out of bounds or if it just sneezed on him.
He did keep it in just by a hair, about 8 inches between the tire and that chalk line. He does get points for taking out the cone though.
6 Rich Rivers, 255, 156.
Ride for Wayne, having to get on that right hand brake quite hard twice through the run.
.286.82 for Wayne Stein, .286.82.
Nice run for Dean Linderman, having to pedal that tractor out, not quite getting up to full boost to below the 230 foot mark.
He was driving that almost like a street legal pickup. .308.96 for Dean Linderman, .308.96 puts him in.
nice run for that 570 cockshuck. Sitting well beyond that 300 foot mark. Looks to be about 310 on that number.
239 and 14 for Mitchell Pratt, 239.14. He had the option to turn that run down or keep it. The weight cuts in at 142.28. 2:11.70 for Luke Metz, 2:1, 1.70. Got those tires aired right down, maybe 9 PSI in there. Trying to get as much traction as he possibly can. Did it in an area we really haven't seen anybody make a pass. He went to the right side fairly deliberately. .191.68.
Going to be sitting about that 210-foot mark.
Luke Metz was the leader, 2:11.70. Paul Ginzel goes 2:11.21, number two. What is that, a Macanudo or a punch? What's he smoking there?
Knowing Kenny, probably cheap.
Swisher Sweet?
A little bigger than that. Definitely a value mark cigar.
.208.79 for Ken Glembieski. .208.79 puts him in third place.
Fighting that line the whole way, got him in the end. DQ out of bounds. looks to be sitting right about that 205 foot mark. Nice pass for the Gian here, 43-20.
For Kyle Brohl, 208.33 puts him into the number four spot. £12,000 Farm Stock Plus. Line them up, please. £12,000 Farm Stock Plus. Drivers to your trackers, get them up. Get them in line, please.
Chris sitting at all that 248-49 foot mark.
£248.87 for Chris Shruba, 248.87. Ed Shoebridge to your tractor for 12,000 Farm Stock Plus, please. Ed Shoebridge to your tractor for 12,000 Farm Stock Plus, please. $250.25 for Brian Geyer, 250.25. That will put him at number one with two to go.
Right side hole definitely giving some issues, coming up quite a bit short of the lead mark.
$200.51 for Jeff Atkinson. One tractor to go, Mitchell.
looks to be sitting right on that 215-foot mark.
He already turned down a 239 and 14, which would have been third place.
Ouch.
213.10, he backs up a lot.
Seen that a couple times this season out on the circuit, getting bit by the test puller bug, so to speak. Definitely a gamble you take being in the first test puller position.
Track does not necessarily improve from the class.
And Ken is going to keep that run.
.242.54 for Ken. 242.54.
Schubert definitely puts him in the number one spot. Key question now is by how far?
.290.04 for Ed Schubert, .290.04.
Picked up some motor work in the past week to the tractor. Not a bad run for Sands. Sit about that 255 foot mark.
.256.48 for Stan, .256.48.
Betty not quite happy with that gear selection choice. Sitting right about that 225 mark. Definitely could say Pat got caught wearing his Superman cape on that one. .219.50 for Pat Genuine. .219.50 feet.
Dan Deere had the candle lit until he got underneath that turbocharger.
Very nice run. Definitely saw a nice cone of flame coming out of the exhaust. Just got caught on the big end.
.268.89, 268.89 for Dan Deere. Mark Stacer and Jared Penzine to your tractors, please. Mark Stacer and Jared Penzine to your tractors, please. But first, let me take a selfie. .264.65, 264.65 for Eric Mulberg. I'm going to hazard a guess and say he didn't change his tire pressure from 10,000 to 12,000. They looked a little bit on the soft side to me. 272.30 for Daniel Stazer, 272.30. That will put him into the number two spot now. Everybody's still chasing Ed Schubert at 290.04. Whatever issues they were, it's probably a gear engagement problem. They got it sorted for Darren Mendrick. .265.86 for Darren Mendrick, .265.86. Mark Stacer, to your turn.
Slow stack fall off at about 130 feet off the line. We can now say there are two guys I see below their stack for the first time.
I think he made a bid for it. Let's see. .279.26 for Nick Geiger. .279.26. That will put him in second spot.
Nice run for Mike Bull, really squealing that turbo at the end. Sitting right about that 255-foot mark.
Once again, Chris Shruba, bring your John Deere back into the arena. You need to go on the dynamometer. Brian Geyer disqualified over horsepower.
.257.58 for Mike Roll, 257.58 feet. Nice run for Jack Chapman. Sitting right about that 265-foot mark.
.267.15 for Jack Chapman, .267.15. There's a challenge for the lead. She needed to beat 290.04. Jenny Foro goes 290.82, your new leader. And after all the hard work that they've been doing the last few weeks and then in the preseason.
Well, the velocity stack in here shut off. Unfortunately, that will quantify as a DQ for Kerr.
.224.55 for Kurt Kalick. .224.55. .266.82 for Cam Kiesler, .266.82.
Going to come up a little bit short there. Do a little driving on that run, trying to get around that soft spot at 130 foot.
.278.04 for Ken Miller, .278.04. Boy, Clutch gave up the ghost late in that run, and not only that, that's not the only thing I heard a problem with. When he let the Clutch out on the starting line, something went crack. I'd want to check my hubs if I was him.
This is definitely a track that will eat hubs out on these tractors. Taking the power here after the sun's gone down.
.260.96 for Mark Staser, .260.96.
Green flags for Jerry Benson.
Getting under the turtle late in the run. sitting there right about that 245 foot mark.
.249.66 for Jared Penzine, .249.66.
Reflex five. That turbocharger exhaust manifold is glowing cherry red, definitely getting plenty of fuel in there. Tough bullet dodged by the 4-0 family.
.282.65 for Mark Osborne, .282.65. Top speeds in this class, the best these guys will do, we need from the neighborhood of 28 to 30 miles per hour ground speed. Consider that they're accelerating a approximately 35 to 38,000 pounds of lead to that speed and then stopping on the space of a football field.
Proposal sitting right about that 285 foot mark.
.286.24 for Nick Capozzo, .286.24. Jacob Messing to your tractor, please. Jacob Messing to your tractor, please.
In there right about where Capozzo is finished. Looks to be about between that 285, 290 foot mark.
We should point out why this tractor is called the Calm Before the Storm.
Actually, it works here today too, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
We have kind of collectively named this tractor. Smiglinski's are on board with it. The Calm Before the Storm, because Paul Jr. normally is pulling in front of his father-in-law. Today, he's in front of his uncle-in-law.
Yep, the Storm Brothers are noted sled operators out of this area. And we thought it was fitting.
Two of the best sled operators in the area, as a matter of fact.
285.42 for Paul Jr. 285.42 puts him in second.
Edgar finishing up right on that 250-foot mark. Sutton Carl, flagman on the big end tonight for us. Also saw his daughter Emily pull. They're 806. In our 9,000-pound farm class earlier, you'll see Carl tomorrow in our hot diesel pickup class with his Duramax Chevrolet. Cross family also suffering some breakage. Take care of the turbo early in the season. This is the first run on this tractor with the new turbo. That'll bring up another tractor not up to the 640 cubic inch limit. Mark Dukoski out of Ubley, the misbehaving Alice Chalmers D21. Both Dukoski tractors going under major surgery in the offseason, trying to find extra horsepower. Biggest reason they're not up to that 640 max is the Alice Chalmers block, 426 cubic inches to begin with, and not a lot of room for reliable growth out of that motor.
I smell biodiesel.
Yep.
.289 for Mark Dukoski,
281.69.
296.03, put Green Energy John Deere number one.
Motor a little hot, seeing steam coming out from under the hood.
.292.05 for Mark Krebs, .292.05 puts him in the second spot.
.292.05 truck class. Jesse, we turn the one that Holler is your leader after 29 trucks with 22 to go. And in pro stock, Ross Morrison still sits number one in the Greenlight Express after 42 track records. Jacob Messing's got to be happy with that run, but he's got to wonder what he left on the table by being that far to the right.
Absolutely lost distance having to get on that brake, bringing it down. I know the numbers normally thrown around for every tap on that brake cost you roughly 5 feet, and he was hard on that brake right about the 260-foot mark.
And he did it, 300.03 feet. Put Buck Nasty at number one.
Green Flex, the press on, National 1066.
Down there. Question is now, did he catch Jacob Messing? Fans, you think he got him?
They're not convinced. They don't seem to think so.
I don't think they're awake. Well, Red fans, did he get him? Charles?
Needed to be 300.03. 305.77. Press on, presses on to number one.
One to go for you Green fans yet.
shut down by those in the gold certified gold.
By rights, you do come back when your shoulder harness is thrown off. What a quick game. Injury issues. Now it's like that.
Well, let's give a big round of applause for coming out here today. Not the one they were looking for. Hopefully we'll be back together and be able to make a pass here tomorrow afternoon.
Eighth place goes to Josh Geiger in a bad news tier. Seven will go to Edgar Cross and Double Cross Four. Six to Martin Dukowski to Mr. Aiden Alice Chalmers. Fifth place to Paul Smolinski Jr. and Paul the Holy Star from John Deere. Fourth to Toner to, excuse me, Nick Caposo on the Cool Attention Shop there. Third, Rick Krebs and the Razor's Edge John Deere. Second, Jacob Messing and Buck Nasty John Deere. And your winner, the 900 pound Super Farm Levi's and the Press On International.
Very nice run there. Herb pedaled it a couple times. Getting that truck to shift. See if he's gonna keep that run or turn it down.
.237.77 for Austin, .237.77.
Diesel, but the taste is horrible.
You're not supposed to drink it.
I didn't. I inhaled it.
262.83 for Drew West, 262.83.
Very low. The idea being that when weight does transfer across the chassis, the front axle and aft chassis will go to parallel with the ground. All that side load out in
those
flex.
Rocky, another one not escaping great pressure this season, taking on one of the bad shafts. Finding that one up. Some new green lights, green flags for Rocky Lumberhead. Party missed the gate by about 15 feet to the side.
He wasn't trying to go right, he was trying to go left into the beer tent. 333.76 for Rocky Boomerang. impressed. Way to go, Joel Girard.
Definitely trying to get out there, catch Rocky. Not quite sure if he got it done, but still a very nice run coming back from having to fix the motor.
Kevin Dukoski to your truck, please. Kevin Dukoski to your truck, please. Wow, I gotta say, for being a trailblazer going with that 6.4 power stroke power plant, doing that, very, very impressive run indeed.
Joel having a lot of help from Derek Rose and DNR Customs, getting this truck back together.
3:37.57 for Joel Girard, number two.
Wow. And Chad putting it out beyond the 300-foot mark. I think there's a truck down there at least. Ah, there's the glow of the taillights. We're good.
One of my favorite things to ever experience is a diesel eclipse.
People can pay good money for off bug spray. All they have to do is come to a tractor pull.
3:11.70 for Chad Schultz, 3:11.70.
A very nice run up in Crosby. Let's see what you can do here today in Armada.
Run she was looking for. I know that is a very big exhaust side on that truck. Not getting the boost built to right about the 200-foot mark. All right, ladies, let's put our hands together for her. Coming out trying to make a pass here. Not quite getting that turbo lit, but nonetheless putting on a good show.
.234.30 for Kelly Ann Sawyer, .234.30. He blew an intake hose off and lost all the boost pressure.
Yeah. Matt's not happy in the cab there. Extra roll of duct tape next time.
You know what? I got to give you credit, Matt, for getting back into the throttle and keeping the sled off the back of you. You've got that experience behind you. Good job there, even though you had a mechanical failure.
Let's put your hands together for Matt. Try and come out here. Making quite a long trip from Freeland for a rough night.
121.14 for Matt Helmrich. 121.14. Is he in two-wheel drive again?
No. Carl, was he in two-wheel drive at the end? Well, yes, he was in two-wheel drive again.
.248.22 for Ryan Hudson, .248.22. Paul Smoglinski.
Right there at that 300-foot mark, looks to be just a little bit shy.
.294.20 for Jerry, .294.20.
All right, ladies, cheer on. Just going to need a little bit of help getting down this track.
Getting under the turbo at the end. Very nice run for Liz Kavanaugh. Looks to be sitting at about that 285-foot mark. I don't know if you noticed it, Charles, but I saw it standing here right about the 220-foot mark. That chassis was arched right up, locked into that track. Definitely not hurting for traction on that run.
288.38 for Liz Kavanaugh, 288.38.
Flags are kept as he slowly builds that heat, bringing that turbocharger to life. This truck, you will also hear that torque converter lock up and unlock in the big end.
Kevin putting it out there right at that 300-foot mark. Did not catch Rocky Hooverette though.
.306.55 for Kevin Dukoski, .306.55. Rundown in the 2.5 trucks. 11th place goes to Matt Helmrich. 10th to Kellyanne Sawyer. 9th place belongs to Austin Venditti. 8th to Ryan Hudson. 7th to Drew West. 6th to Liz Kavanaugh. 5th spot goes to Jerry Ponce. 4th to Kevin Dukoski. 3rd to Chad Schultz. 2nd to Joel Girard and Rocky Bouverette. And the GMC Duramax is your winner in the 2.5 diesel trucks.
Nice run for Jed Bushy, sitting right at that 260-foot mark. So far, he's in the lead for the wheelie competition.
.263.37 for Jed Bushy, .263.37. I'm going to assume he's going to keep that run. He is headed back to the pit area. You can hear those bigger cubic inches going to work on a true limited pro.
Absolutely, 515 cubic inch limit on the limited pro stock class. Mike definitely out beyond the 300 foot mark.
.313.68 for Mike Cross,
Coming up short for Paul Sr., who looks to be sitting about that 285-foot mark.
.281.85 for Paul Smoglinski Sr., .281.85. Puts him at number two.
Definitely safe to say he's beyond that 300 foot mark. Did he catch Mike Cross?
Needed to get .313.68 if he was going to catch Mike Cross on the double cross forward. Ron Tatro puts code red at .312.31, second place.
Dennis sitting down here right about that 296 foot mark, 296, 297 area.
296.93 for Dennis Herrer, 296.93. So Mike Cross is your winner. Ron Tatro, number two. Dennis Herrer, three. Paul Smoglinski, four. And Jed Bushy, number five.
Carrying a bit of nose weight, probably 900 or so pounds out of the front. That is on purpose. First time on a brand new track, you don't want to stand it up. You just want it to be a nice, easy, smooth run. There's nothing left of an agricultural tractor in this machine except for the engine block, and even that is actually an aftermarket piece. DT-466, but recast by Hypermax. It uses all custom-built parts. There's nothing left of a farm tractor in this at all, despite the fact that it's called a pro stock.
Green lights and green flags for Beverage H. Pay attention, this is Home Turns Point.
He just blew off an intake pipe, not a major problem. So dumped all the boost, blew the left side or right side shield a little bit. It's a pipe that came off. It's not harmful to the engine what happened, but it's not necessarily something they can fix in the next 3 minutes. That's all part of debuting a brand new tractor. You've got to put on the track and see what happens with it. There's not a dynamometer you can go to that's going to hold this thing back and really load it up properly.
No, but they definitely have one at their disposal. We are going to need a tow tractor, please. Tow tractor to the tractor.
I won't say bad luck because you can't call it that. That's just part of David on the machine. The good news is it is still running. It's something that can be worked on. We'll get to see this thing in anger tomorrow.
Let's put a big round of applause together for Tom Harmon trying to debut this tractor here tonight. Not a class for him, but coming to make a run for you guys in Armada.
And at this point,